What's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And in this video, we're gonna talk about writing functions in M. Do you need to write one or don't you? Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date on all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, I was working on a data model for a workshop that Adam, Alex Powers, and myself are doing at an upcoming conference. And I was working on something and I needed to write a function. And then I was talking to Alex, of course, because it's M. And he was like, well, Patrick, let me show you. So you guys know how we like to do a guy in a cube. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So I was setting up incremental refresh. And when I went to go and put that range start and range end parameter on my table, it said, hey, you can't do this because this needs to be a data type. And so I was like, oh, geez. So I got to go back. Alex was the one setting up the data. And I was like, I got to call Adam. It's 20 million rows of data. And I'm going to need him to convert this to a daytime. And then I thought, wait a minute. You already did a video on how to convert integers to dates. So you can use them or dates to integers or something like that. I already did a video on that with incremental refresh. So why not just write a function? Let me show you. So what I did was right click right here. It said new query, blank query. And I named this fn get date. Then I opened up the advanced editor. So I got rid of all this stuff that was here. And I typed something that looked like this. So this is gonna be my IR param. And then I said, go to date.from IR param. Because what I want to do is I want to convert the date time to a date so I can use it in my filter. And then I clicked done. So I went back over here and I went to my advanced editor and made myself some space. Love the IntelliSense. And then I said range start. And then right here, fn underscore range end. So basically it takes those parameters that I created, because when you set it up for incremental refresh, your range start and your range end parameters must be date times. But the date in my model was just a date. It won't compare a date and a date time. Power Query just won't do that. So I needed to convert those parameters in the dates, but I still needed to keep the parameters date time for the whole incremental process to recognize that they are date time. So I can go and configure incremental refresh, because if it didn't, when I go to the incremental refresh dialog, it was like, hey, you need some date times in there. Okay. So that's why I wrote that function. And so I showed it to Alex. It was so funny. He was excited because I was writing M. But what he said was, he was like, hey, look at this. You didn't even use a let or an in. I'm like, no, because it returns a value. He goes, but there's some coding best practices you should use, Patrick. And so if you take a look at the function itself, it says as any. He was like, Power Query will do some implicit conversions, but you need to explicitly state the type that you want to accept and the type that you want to output. It's just good coding practice. I'm like, all right, that's a good idea, Alex. So what I did was, I know my parameters are always going to be date times. So I said, I want to accept date times. And then right outside, right before the go to, I want to output a date. So I'm explicitly specifying those in my code. And if I click done here, you'll see now I can't enter anything but a date. So if I type Patrick here, it barks at me. But if I put a date, it works. Now, if I get rid of those explicit data types and I go back, notice that I could type whatever I want. It doesn't complain. It doesn't do anything. With the number, it actually will convert it to a date, because under the covers, a date is just an integer. So as a best practice, you should always specify the data type you want to accept and the data type you want to output, which is really cool. But then it got me to thinking, I'm like, wait a minute, do you really need this function? Because all I'm doing is converting the date time to a date. Why don't I just use the date.from directly in the code? Let me show you what I'm talking about. So if I head back over here and go to advanced editor, instead of this, I can just do date.from. It's going to yield the exact same result, just like that, and click done. You'll see if I go here, it's going to take a second or so, but it'll return my data set. And so you need to make a decision. Do you really need a function? Maybe. Maybe you don't. If you're going to reuse it, probably should create a function. If you're not going to reuse it throughout other queries, maybe you don't need a function if it's a simple function. And also, as a best practice, you should explicitly declare, you know, your data types that you're going to accept and that you're going to return. All right. What do you guys think? Have you ran into this before? Do you have any questions, comments? I'd love to know. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.